Now let's ask our expert of this week, what is the biggest fashion trend going on right now? It has to be the quiet luxury, the old money look. Stop. It's not for everybody. You have to be careful if you're short.
What?
Because the old money aesthetics incorporate longer hemlines, oversized blazers. A lot of these traditionally cut pieces are not the most friendly on someone who's short, can look disproportionate. I'm 5'2". If you're petite like myself, here is the do's and don'ts. First, let me thank today's video sponsor, Goelia. They've been around since 1995. Every piece I have received is top-notch quality. Behind that is their philosophy. Higher quality equals less consumption because you wear them longer, and that's how we protect our environment. Everything I'm wearing today and my size are in the links down below. Use my code CHI25 for 25% off your order. Number one is to choose the right color combination. Solids are the easiest, especially for someone who is shorter. Quiet luxury looks use just neutrals. Blacks, whites, grays, navies. Easiest to mix together and create that harmonious look. Make sure you're staying away from anything that is too attention grabbing, because the whole point of quiet luxury... Wait, what if I'm a prince kind of girl? Well, then you're just like me. I love prints. Stripes is your answer. Go with black and white stripes. These are the most classic. Thunder stripes work much better on someone who's shorter, because wider stripes can expand you horizontally, and that can make you look bigger than you are and even shorter than you are. This cardigan is my favorite, the gold buttons, and it's made of wool. That's what makes you look more rich looking. The silhouette. Super important. Classy cuts, so that means you want to ditch anything that is too tight. Wide-leg pants are the timeless classic, especially when it comes to the summer looks. For the quiet luxury style, you want to get a pair of white color. But if you're shorter like myself, you want to be more careful. The number one thing to look for? Fabrics. Like this, you want to make sure it's thick enough. When it's thicker, it gives the fabrics more structure, and that's what makes sure it's flowy or breathable. Thicker fabrics also comes across as more expensive. Here's the secret. To make it look flattering on a shorter person, you want to choose the right length. This pair is 29 inches in the inseam, so it's perfect to wear with heels. When I'm wearing 3-inch heels, this is draping over on top of my shoes. It's covering part of my heels. My feet look like an extension of my legs. Speaking of classic leg shapes, I have to talk about flare legs, and this are the heaven sent. If you have shorter legs like me, because flare legs are fitted on your thighs and they flare out under your knees, this subtle change is gonna give the eye illusion of longer legs. Our four-way stretchy fabrics, they made a big difference on my buttocks. It really hugs my curves without being too tight. And that's the thing with quiet luxury. You want to ditch anything that looks overly sexy, but you do still want to look feminine. Now let's talk about shorts. These typically are casual. How do you make sure they look rich but still are comfortable? The key is to look for a structure. You want to go with something like this. This is an A-line shaped shorts. The silhouette makes sure it's not clingy to your legs. That's what makes sure they're comfortable enough. And at the same time, they're not too tight. They make you look elegant. Also love how versatile these shorts are. On a hot summer day, all white look. Striped tank top. I have very sensitive skin. That's why I'm very careful with anything that touches my skin. Because they're made of acetate, they're very gentle on my skin and feel smooth, and even more so than cotton. Here's my favorite way to pull off a quiet luxury look without being overwhelmed. Wear a matching set. The matching sets look intentional. They make you look rich without looking like you're trying too hard. And that's why you're always gonna look polished. This set has a blazer and a skirt. My favorite part? The fabrics. This is made of acetate. It's semi-man-made, but it's derived from natural fibers. So that's what makes sure it's thick enough. This is breathable, but it also has enough structure so that the fabrics hold its shape, and that's key to make sure you look expensive. I also love how versatile this blazer is because it's short sleeve that makes it look more casual, but because it has a structured shoulder that makes it look more formal. So you can really dress up or dress down. It's black and white, neutrals and no colors, and how do you make sure it doesn't look boring? That's why you gotta use accessories. Silk scarf like this, super versatile. There are so many different ways you can use it to pull up the old money aesthetics. Use it as a bustier because it's big enough on a hot summer day for your vacation by the pool or on the ocean. But of course, use it as your scarf any way you like. I really love how it adds dimension to a very simple color scheme outfit. Besides, I love the prints. These are the world map. This is a travel map of Goelia. I love the old world charm of this map. And it uses the double printing technology, which is used by the top luxury brands in the world. But of course, at Goelia, these are much more affordable prices. Because the old money aesthetic is so simple in terms of the silhouette, in terms of the color combination, one thing that you can use to make sure it doesn't look too boring, interesting necklines. My personal favorite are the halter neck. They can make any casual top look more intentional because the neckline looks more polished and therefore entire outfit is gonna look more put together. Besides, if you're petite with a shorter torso, which is very common, halter neck really works good because it extends your torso length, so it gives the eye the illusion of a more balanced torso. Now let's talk about shoes. They're so important to make sure your entire outfit look put together. First of all, you want to make sure you avoid anything that is too trendy. What I mean by that is there are certain designs that are everywhere this season. For example, luxe soles. Even some of the famous designers have them. And that's exactly what you don't want for the old money aesthetics, because you want to look classic, elegant. You don't want anything that is just on trend for this season or the next season and it completely goes away. My favorite are the loafers. These have never changed since the beginning of time. So you cannot go wrong with a pair of loafers, and I have got this design for different colors. In terms of the colors, skin tone shoes are always my go-to. Number one, these are so easy to go with just about any bottom. And number two, because we're shorter, that's the key. You want to match the color of your shoes with the color of your skin, because that's gonna trick the eye to believe your feet are an extension of your legs, and that's how it can make us look longer and leaner. If you are petite, whether or not you're going for the old money aesthetics, you do want to pay a lot of attention to your body proportion. So that means everything you wear, it needs to be hitting you at the right length. You don't want your top to be too long, but of course you don't want it to be too short, because a lot of us, especially for those of us who carry weight in our midsection or on our hips and thighs, you don't want anything that's making you self-conscious. Because everything that petite women wear should be proportioned just right. Everything for my clothing line is modeled by women 5'4 and under, and that way you can know exactly how it's gonna look on you. If you haven't yet, make sure you go to petitedressing.com and check out my clothing line for petites just like you.